MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's on to Game 5 of the National League Championship Series between the Atlanta Braves and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, this is still anyone's series here as we get ready for Game 5.
Well, they're down 3-1, so it's do or die time now. That's not a good place to be, obviously, but we do see some teams play their best when their backs are up against the ropes. The key is to just take it one game at a time and not worry about how many more wins you need.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Walker Buehler is charged with keeping their hopes alive on the mound here in the League Championship Series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, Matt, this guy keeps his team in the ballgame. He's won 2 of his last 3 starts, so he's been throwing the ball really well. And one of the keys for this guy is getting early outs to keep his pitch count down. If he can do that, he should be able to get into the 7th or 8th inning in this one here today.
2-1. Temperature starting to drop as the sun goes down. 56 degrees here at first pitch. A swing and it's popped in the air back behind first. Muncy will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone. And now a moment to show you the lineup for Atlanta in this one. What's your take as they try to win an NL championship here on the road, Mark?
Matty, the key in this one for this lineup is they got to stay staunch in the middle of the plate. They can't start swinging at everything or this guy will abuse them. They'll start flipping up the rosin bag. They have to sit over those 17 inches and hold to that.
In now, Freddie Freeman. 2 balls and a strike to Freeman. Ozzie Albies is on deck. The 3-1 pitch. And he lays off here, ball 4, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
The hitter was dug in looking for something to hit, but he would have needed a telephone pole to hit that thing way out of the zone.
Now at the plate here is Ozzie Albies. Lifetime against this pitcher. He's 1-for-5. The 1-1 home is swung on and missed for strike number 2. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
The 2-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball 4.
And the payoff pitch pulled toward right center field. Taylor is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are 2 away.
That is cool. The third baseman, Austin Riley.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Austin Riley. Freeman leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike 2. Here comes the 1-2. shot to third. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Braves strand one. The Dodgers coming up, and we are scoreless. Max Fried will do the pitching with a trip to the World Series on the table. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, getting a look at lefty Max Fried. Man, has this guy come a long way in a short time. This guy's as good a left-handed starting pitcher as there is in the game. Smooth gas, 95 to 97 miles an hour. Good overhand curveball. He'll mix the steady diet of changeups in. When he starts to put all three of those pitches together, look out. We're looking at one of the top left-handed pitchers in all of baseball.
Fouled off. Fouled away. Again, another foul ball.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Struck him out.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him. He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
Standing in now, Corey Seager. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
One out, nobody on. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Here's another 1-2. Inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with. A long at bat like this in the first inning can reveal a lot.
Looking for back-to-back K's to start the game. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
And he fouls this one off. And it's fouled away.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
Sent on the ground out to second. Albies scoops it up, and he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Batting third.
Now a moment for the Los Angeles Dodgers starting lineup. Dero, tell us about this lineup as they try to keep their playoff hopes alive.
Well, Matt, this goes for both lineups. They know they're dealing with a tough test in a pitcher's park, but they can't let that bother them too bad, or they'll walk out of here 3-4 game set, 0-12, 0-15. They have to find a way to stay within themselves. Line drive approach. One will carry out of here if they get it.
2-1 to count to Trey Turner. Here's the 2-1 home. Shin high. That's taken for a ball. Max Muncy would be next if they can keep this inning alive. The 3-1 pitch. Swing and a liner, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Next up is Max Muncy, man at first after the two-out walk. The 1-1 is taken for ball two. Two out with the man at first. Turner's on his horse on his way to second. Pitch inside, the throw, and it skips in as he steals the bag easily.
Some managers treat the postseason as a time to be aggressive, and that's exactly the case here. They had the speed burner on the move, and it worked out nicely for him. Just got to drive him in now.
Ready with the 3-1. Squared that one up just a little late. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. Fouled off. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
Now to the plate, Will Smith. For his career in this matchup, he's 1-for-3. 2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. Fouled away. Two men are on with two men out. Fastball right back to the mound. On the first, and the Dodgers come up with nothing as that ends the inning. Couple of walks in the inning, but nothing on the scoreboard. More on tap from game five after this. All set for the start of the inning, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Adam Duvall. Here's a fly ball, well hit. Back goes Taylor to the track, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall, and he is into second base with a leadoff double.
Man, it looked like the pitcher was trying to get him to go fishing at a pitch out of the strike zone. He went for it all right, but he managed to catch all of that baseball, lacing it for a double in the outfield. That's a great piece of hitting.
Next up, Eddie Rosario, and he'll hit with a chance to push across the game's first run.
Yeah, great RBI opportunity here, but at the very least, he needs to find a way to advance that runner to third. Small things like that in a tight game can make a big difference.
Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Here now the 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Another 2-2 offering, and he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Batting seven.
So a runner on second with one down now. And up next, the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud. Set and the 1-2 pitch. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. And with two away, here's a look at our updated playoff brackets. And the question on everyone's mind is, will we be able to punch our first ticket to the World Series after tonight's ball game? Next, it'll be Dansby Swanson. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for Atlanta. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Justin Turner. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Next for the Dodgers, A.J. Pollock. Lifetime versus this pitcher. He's one for two. Hits this one hard the other way. And that will be the first base hit of the ballgame for the Dodgers.
That's the difference in today's games. Pitchers will throw any pitch in any count. But the batter was able to deliver on a 3-2 breaking ball.
Into the box now, Chris Taylor. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes. And there he goes towards second. Pitch outside. The throw way late, and he's in there easily at second.
You know, I like the aggressiveness there. They haven't cracked the scoreboard at this point, so it's clear they're trying to manufacture something by forcing the action. We'll see if it works out for them.
Fastball well outside.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. There's a drive out toward the alley in right center. Runner score as the Dodgers grab the early 1-0 lead. The relay, and he is in there with an RBI triple.
Well, there's one way to get our first one of the game across. Good hustle there on an RBI triple, and they're in good shape to possibly make it 2-0 with another base hit here.
Stepping in now, Walker Buehler. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Taylor takes his lead at third with one away. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Hit on the ground out to short. Swanson picks it up. Only play is going to be a first, so score it as an RBI ground out as the lead moves to 2-0 now.
And here with the infield back, they were giving him the run on a ground ball, so he just takes advantage of that and drives the run home. Good approach.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Mookie Betts struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, Sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
The 2-1 is looked at for ball three.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
And it's fouled away. Now the 3-2 pitch. Curveball, but a good job to lay off, and he works out the free pass.
Now
yeah, the pitching coach would hate to go to the bullpen this early in the game, but sometimes you have no choice. On the flip side, he might just get in his face a little bit out there, try to challenge him, wake him up from his funk. Either way, we'll see how it works.
Stepping in next, Corey Seager. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 2-2. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder giving chase. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Gotta love a night at the ballpark. These fans certainly are. More coming up from Game 5 after this. So stepping in is Max Fried, 9-1-2 due up.
You know, these next couple innings are really important for these guys. I know they're only down by a couple, but they need to get something going on offense to keep pace, even though it's early.
Fouled off.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2.
Not sure if that was a great take or if he got locked up on a two-seamer running away, but either way, it worked out well for him. That's a well-thrown pitch, though.
Bat explodes as this has popped up, and he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down.
The right fielder, number 12, Jorge.
So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Jorge Soler to hit next. The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys, because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Now the 2-1 pitch. The count now at 2-2.
Hey, this is a huge at-bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. Down in order go the Braves. They trail it here 2-0. And we're back for the bottom of the third. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already worked out 3 walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Bottom of the third now, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Trey Turner. Hit to third. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy's had a monster postseason so far.
To the plate now, Max Muncy. And that sinking fastball didn't sink, it stayed high, using the slide step to try to control the running game.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
And that's in there above the belt, so it's even now, 2-2.
Hey, you could tell right there the hitter was almost fooled by that pitch, expecting the nasty slider to break down and away, and it hung in the middle of the plate. Too late for him to pull the trigger.
Turner on at first, nobody out. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
And again a throw, and he'll dive back in safely. At the plate, Will Smith. Pitch misses low. The throw down. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
Well, they threw over there multiple times thinking he was going to try to swipe that bag, so they were onto him, but he just waited it out and took off when he had the chance. Nice job of base running there.
Now a spin and a throw back to second, and the runner back. One out and a runner on second base. All even now, 2-2. From the belt, the pitch. Now a swing, and he pops it foul behind the plate. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
Up next to the Dodgers, the third baseman.
Digging in will be Justin Turner, runner in scoring position with two gone. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Working for the punch out and the offering. He loses him on ball four.
The left fielder, number 11. AJ.
Next, here is AJ Pollock. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Here's the 1-1 pitch, grounded to third. And the two out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Dodgers strand a couple as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up Ozzie Albies. 3-2 pitch. Right side, defense aligned perfectly. Turner fields it cleanly and safe, says the first base umpire, as the throw was too late.
Now batting.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint, but nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher's still one good pitch away from getting a double play.
You know, D-Roll, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher, and there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a leadoff single on an infield ground ball.
In now, Austin Riley. outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now. Hit sharply on the ground. To second for one. On to first, and they get them both.
The center fielder, number 14, Adam Duvall.
So base is empty now after the double play. And next it'll be the outfielder, Adam Duvall. The 1-1. Misses, ball two.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
No runs, two hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. A swing and a miss at the slider at 88, 2-2.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
The 2-2. Looked at and the count moves full.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Two out, nobody on. Inside, he misses ball four.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
So next to bat will be Eddie Rosario. The 1-1 home. Duvall is off a first with two away. Three balls and a strike to the Braves left fielder.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
The 3-1 pitch is in there for a full count now, 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Now the 3-2 pitch. This is skied into short left center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Braves strand one. They're down 2-0. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder Chris Taylor. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two, and so now the Braves will get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. The 2-1 home. Ball hit out to Albies at second base. He's got it, and he's set down, one away. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And, whoa, you see the big number. How about 99 for a top speed? Not too many guys around the league can match that. One gone now in the Dodger fourth, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Walker Buehler. Two runs, three hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. Lays off the slider that time, 2-1. Called strike two. Weak grounder down the first baseline. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now.
The batter, the right fielder, Mookie Betts.
Two down, no one on base. And up next, one of the terrific talents in the game, Mookie Betts. Two and one now to Mookie.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
Down the left field line and deep. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Another full count pitch home. Popped him up. Darno waits on it. And the inning is over. Dodgers down in order, but they're on top 2-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the Braves offense with their manager, Brian Snicker, during the commercial break. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Stepping in once again is Travis d'Arno. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. And here's a slider for a called strike, and he's behind 1 and 2 now. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
Into the box, Dansby Swanson. Swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
Well, you know you've got it working on the mound when they're swinging right through it, even when you're putting it right down the middle of the strike zone. Not the greatest of game plans, though.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
I'll tell you right now, this guy has a shutout going, and it's been all business. He's not messing around trying to pick at corners. He's being aggressive in the zone, and he's attacking each and every one of these hitters up to this point.
So now to the plate, Max Fried. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from 5 shutout innings.
Here comes the 1-2. Misses for the second ball. Two out, nobody on. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
The next 3-2. Hit in the air down the right field line. On the move is Betts. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Braves are shut down 1-2-3. They trail things here 2-0. Tuki Toussaint gets the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief.
Number 62.
Here's Corey Seager. The 2-1 is taken for strike two. The 2-2. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Center fielder on the run. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
The batter, number 6, second baseman, Trey Turner.
Up next, Trey Turner. It was a base hit last time up. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Popped him up. D'Arno moving to his left. And he makes the catch for the second out.
Now batting, first baseman, Max Muncy.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Max Muncy, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Into the corner and slicing foul. Lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in his at bat.
Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Two out, nobody on. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're up 2-0. Stepping in for the Braves, Jorge Soler. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning. Now the 1-1 pitch. Like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 2-2. Hit hard right back up the middle, and he's got a leadoff single.
The first baseman, number 5. Ready. Freeze.
Now here's the Dodgers skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So as he departs, he'll remain responsible for the man left to board, but he cannot lose this one. Shane Green takes over on the mound here with nobody out in the sixth inning.
For the Dodgers, number 28, Shane Green.
Stepping in now, Freddie Freeman. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
You like the modern style of baseball, here it is. Both starters kept their teams in the game. It's close right now. Now we hand it over to the nasty bullpens. Let's see what matchups are going to take place.
And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Always tough to issue a free pass, but especially troublesome when you give up a single right before that to start the inning. We'll see if he can figure out a way to wiggle out of this.
So up steps Ozzie Albies. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Off-speed pitch, good for strike two.
The Braves have been looking for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a big time for that.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Ripped on the ground to first. Reined in to second for one. Onto the pitcher covering in time. It's a double play.
Not what you expect from your three-hole hitter when the first two guys get on base. That's pretty deflating. But now we'll see if the cleanup guy can still pick up the runner at third.
Now, Austin Riley misses ball two. Soler on third with two out. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Now on 3-2, as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
And the payoff pitch. And he fouls this one off. The next 3-2. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Hit hard on the ground at first. Muncy will win the race to first easily, and that ends the inning. One left for Atlanta. They're still down. It's 2-0. And now in the box, Will Smith. Popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
Albies picks it up, and the throw to first is in time, one gone.
Not a lot up you can do with that pitch. That fastball just baseman. Ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
So here is Justin Turner. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Bases are empty, one man out. Swings through it for strike number two.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
had to protect there with two strikes, and he just got it off the end of the bat. Not much of a problem for the infield at that point.
At the plate, A.J. Pollock. That's right there at the belt, one and two now.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
The 1-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Again, a 1-2. And he got him. Dodgers down in order, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Corey Knebel will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Cody Bellinger is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch. Now to the plate, here is Adam Duvall. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel, he's 1-for-5. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, 3 balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
And a good take there, as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the 7th. It's ball 4.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you. So we'll see if that's the case here.
Next to hit is Eddie Rosario. Flew out last time up. Fastball is looked at for strike 2.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
And it's fouled away. Nobody out, runner on first. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
And he lays off there, ball 4. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Into the box now, Travis d'Arnaud. Travis d'Arnaud with an even 2-2 count now.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
He's set. Here's the 2-2.
He's already walked 2 in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His 3rd punch out of the game.
Really important time for a strikeout there, guys. Tying run at first, so objective number 1 is stranding him on base. And now with 1 out, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that run.
Joe Kelly takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away.
Joe Kelly.
And now Dansby Swanson, and he just misses inside with the fastball there. Lifetime versus Joe Kelly, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at bats. Now the 2-1, a swing and a drive sent out toward the gap, and gone. A dramatic home run that gives them their first lead of the game. So a three-run shot to left center, and Atlanta's taken a 3-2 lead.
I'm sure at the plate right there, he's thinking stay up the middle, hard line drives to either gap. He did it one better, giving his team the lead right there with a huge three-run bomb.
Ronald Acuna will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Acuna is retired, two down now.
The right fielder.
In is Jorge Soler.
Jorge Soler.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
The 2-1. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. On the move is Taylor. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the tradition.
But the Braves do pick up three on the strength of this three-run home run. Get up and stretch. It's now 3-2 Atlanta. A.J. Minter will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 33, A.J. Minter.
And now here is Chris Taylor. These two have not faced each other at the major league level. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Ready on 1-2. Popped up. Freeman is there. One out.
Now batting, left fielder, Cody Bellinger.
So here's Cody Bellinger. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number 7. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Now here's the pitch.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
And that hole at bat, I feel like he really didn't want to challenge him. And I'm really surprised by that, because I think this is a guy in the bottom third of the order you have to go right after.
Next, it'll be Mookie Betts. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
One there. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. We'll see Freddie Freeman start things off when we return. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. Braves lead this one 3-2. Phil Bickford has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 52, Phil Bickford.
Ready to begin the 8th, and into bat next, one of the best run producers in the game, the left-handed hitting first baseman Freddie Freeman. The 1-1 home. A ball and two strikes now. Here comes the 1-2. Is looked at for ball number 2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Here now the 2-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Here now the 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the 8th inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
So now to the plate, Ozzie Albies. Popped him up. Smith is under it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Now batting, third baseman, Austin Riley.
And now the Atlanta number 4 hitter, Austin Riley. No thump out of him in this game so far, as might be expected. He's 0 for 3. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. He'll try again, 1-2. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. So it's a solo shot to dead center, and it's given the Braves a 4-2 lead. Certainly a tape measure shot there as we take a look at it with our show track technology. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity, so it comes as no surprise that it carried as far as it did. Into the box, Adam Duvall. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. One for the Braves in the inning, and it comes courtesy of the long ball. Home half of the 8th coming up. It's now a 4-2 Atlanta lead. Tyler Matzek is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 68.
Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Matzek comes set. Here's the 1-1. And they'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
The 2-1 home. It's a swinging strike. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 2-2. Davis swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. And in a 4-2 game, time to check the numbers here. It's our starter comparison as we see how these two performances stack up against one another. The speedy Trey Turner digs in now. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now.
Now batting, first baseman, Max Muncy.
Two away for the Dodgers here in the eighth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. Here comes the 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Still down by a count of 4-2. Blake Treinen enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. So striding in to start the ninth is Eddie Rosario, trying to pad their lead here before the bottom of the inning. The 1-1.
Count for 2-1.
Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch. Might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
Stepping in now, Travis d'Arnaud. Little chopper back to the mound. He'll go to the bag for one. Over to Muncy, and they double him up.
Good pitch on the ground ball there, and an even better job up the middle to take it himself and turn two. Pretty smooth.
Dansby Swanson will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts, let's take you back to inning number 7, and a big blow here as his 3-run home run accounted for perhaps the biggest blow of the ball game. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. And the sinker runs too low here as he loses him. It's ball 4.
Now batting, number 68.
Aure Adrianza will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 23, Aure Adrianza.
Taken, called strike 2 on the inside part of the plate, 1-2 now. Swinging a soft liner, and as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Braves strand one as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Will Smith comes out of the bullpen to shut things down
now
here in the ninth.
Atlanta, number 51, Will Smith.
Here now is Will Smith. And obviously they'll need a ninth inning rally here if this series is going to make it to a game six. Break with the slider there, catches the inside for a strike. This is on the ground over to first. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. On the recovery throw is in time to get the out at first. What a heads-up play.
The third baseman, Justin Turner.
So next to hit is Justin Turner. His career line against Will Smith. He's 0 for 4. One out, nobody on. Ground ball right side. And he'll take this on to first, and they're down to their final out, two away.
The pitcher, number 49. Wait. Right at
Albert
your attention,
Pujols.
Please.
We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 55, Albert Pujols.
The 1-1 pitch. Two-run game, last of the ninth with two away. The Dodgers down to their final strike. High fly ball out to straightaway center. And the Braves have done it. They're your National League champions.
Well, they've taken care of business all season long, and tonight was no exception. They've proven to be the best team in the National League. Now it's time to see if they can become the best in the entire game. Celebrate tonight. And the World Series is next. Congrats to the NL champs.
For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our excellent crew, this is Matt Vaskirjan saying so long. You've been watching the National League Championship Series.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Atlanta Braves, 4 runs on 5 hits, no errors.